October 11th, the Sunday before Columbus Day, 2015, here on the Felt 980, which is a 29er. Okay, we're going to go down on what is the longest walking trail. Crabs out here, there's fish, there's eel, there's raccoons. You can see perhaps the city right ahead of us. Kind of disappointing people on that longer trail, which is off to the right. You can't see it. I have a chest mount, but it's over in that direction to my 3 o'clock. We'll go this way. It is a beautiful October day before Columbus Day. Hello. No, I don't think there's any bicyclists. There are other bicyclists here that have been. I've seen them. Kind of cool, especially today, it's so beautiful. Hello. And that was gorgeous day also, but this is even nicer. Wow, what a difference from even a year ago, actually back a couple of years ago, it was snow. A couple of years in a row, I think, right around this date. Of course, back in 2012, Sandy had roared through, and the cleanup was on. There's a turnpike. Maybe that's where the bicyclists went. It's hard to tell. You need the rain. More down south than up here in northern part of Jersey. So, I'm not sure if I'll even try. Get down real quick, but now this is a wall right here. That's all it is. This is access to some kind of control here, but just walking up a little bit here. I guess there might be a trail there. You can't see it, but there's active railroad route right here. And so there is a little bit of a trail. And I can see it goes all the way out somewhere. Okay. Not much of a route back there, at least. Not worth crossing the road bed there, the railroad bed. Look like it went far. So I'm back at the little bridge. Kind of an access road. And back again. And I just gone over to the right here. And that went nowhere. Maybe a 100 feet. It has an egret, two egrets, and they're also access to the over these, but this is exactly the way we came in. Photography taking place here, but not the great source of bird photos. Okay, we're on the platform, and we were just out to where I'm facing now. We're on the wooden part of the platform. Some parts of them appear to be pontoons, like the part we're about to go on. And more than that, we can't go very fast here. Should look to be recycled plastic that was used. It's very soft. I think in winter it's very hard. Well, it's harder right now because the sun is not as strong here. And it's almost mid-October. So it's a little bit different than it was, which was very soft. Odd feeling, but it still is an interesting sight. Full suspension bike would be nice to hear. It really is ripply. Makes your voice go like this. And this is all part, I believe, of the Korte. You can see the blind out there. I do see a lot of photographers out here. So it's a good place. More for walking, I think, than bicycling. But like for me, it's very convenient to get here. It's just so different. You know, the atmosphere here is so different, the environment, that that's why I like the ride, even though, as you'll see, I just was cut off, as I said earlier, from a couple of miles of one way of the paths. It's not some place where you can go 20 or 30 miles. Now, the other thing is, I hope the chest mount is not creaking. Boy, I was having problems with that throughout the summer. This is the first video I've recorded. It will be the first one I've uploaded in a couple weeks, maybe. Seems like I'm starting to switch back to riding the motorcycle more than the bicycles. To me, this is just something different. Even though I've gone here many times now with bicycling and a couple of times walking and just photographing, it's different. Kind of run out of places that are within easy reach over the years, you know? Give me incentive to bicycle. As winter approaches, it's almost like I'm, you know, back on the motorcycle more than the bicycle, as I said. We're about to exit the Korte Park, and for a while anyway, go on the streets, because some of those are, it's just interesting. A little bit different for this part of Jersey than, it seems like a micro environment within a larger urban environment. A railroad, former railroad employee was talking to me all about this particular line here. I used to maintain it. I want to pull over just to show you the beautiful red leaves of autumn. So you don't see it, but high voltage lines. The new World Trade Center was basically a mountain of garbage, or several of them. But well done there. You know, it looks a lot better than you would expect, and it's just different. And you know, that's probably. That's a route that probably is from where I was earlier. Who knows? Just don't want to violate any no trespassing signs. I've heard also, which is really interesting, from the person I was talking to, that they've seen coyotes out here. And there's certainly plenty of room for them to run around. If they have raccoons and muskrats and other stuff, certainly probably a bunch of cats, rats, so there's plenty to feed on. I haven't seen one personally here. I've seen foxes though, not here but other parts of North Jersey. So we're out in the street, an access road here, but former ball field, which I think is shut off now. Tire cushions the ride a bit. Now I'll take one of these side streets. Some big developments here where that car just went. Here's where I'll go. And probably just run this until it runs out. Hope there's not too much creaking from the GoPro chest mount. It's a GoPro 3 Plus Black. It works very well, so I don't see a reason for going to the GoPro 4. I also use this in a helmet chin bar mount. Works extremely well with a microphone running inside the helmet. That's a maybe it's a gym. There's a load of places around here. Retail, but mostly commercial. And an athletic club is located there because of all these new, I think they're all condos, huge developments. There's also some big office buildings here, very close to Giant Stadium or the MetLife Stadium, which you may or may not be able to see from here. And we're in Lyndhurst, I think. I'm not sure. Hard to tell, you know, all these towns that surround it. But you see, they're very pretty. And they are convenient. It's convenient to live here, especially if you take a train into New York, because it's a short ride to the train station. But I will say, when that Route 3 gets busy, you probably have to go some back way, which you probably can to get to a train station. We cross the commuter. The commuter lines just a few minutes ago. So there's probably a way to go kind of the back way without getting on Route 3 and get to a train station. Or if the time is right and you don't have a mass of traffic out here, you could easily get to a major train station and get a train to almost any place in Jersey or over into New York. It's still surprising how close you are to the metropolis is here, and this densely populated corridor. And even though it's an office park here, just the look is just different. A little glimpse into the way this part of the Northeast, on the border of Mid-Atlantic Northeast, used to look like. It passed through in the Meadowlands, at least some parts of it. Those are townhouses or condos or both coming up on them. So quite an extensive set of condos here. Surprising the location, and the weather also is simply fabulous for October 11th. Actually, cool wind. The sun is very warm though. Yeah, it's cool right here, but refreshingly cool. Not cold at all. Cool is in like the 60s. Very pretty. Let's see where this goes. I'm gonna have to make a U-ey. Yeah, this might be another highway right here. We're very close to a major highway. You never know it from our surroundings, but okay, I think I'm switching off to another street. So, hard to tell. Obviously not used to making a stop there. Hey, it's probably always no one else there. Medieval times. Like a restaurant, you can watch jousting and medieval stuff and costumes. Straight ahead of us. More offices on the right and left. More Phragmites on the extreme left. Down a few hundred yards. Fall and winters were with cool temperatures to frigid single degree temperatures and lots of snow, lots of rain, lots of flooding. All right, we're almost at the turnaround point to go back to the park where I'm parked. Something smells great. It smells like chocolate. nice car. Get out this way. Looks somebody's getting out of smoke. Hey, my old Focus. That's from several years ago, maybe as much as 10. Advantages of this bike. Off curbs and everything. Without bending everything. Bending the wheel and cracking the frame. Oh. Alright. Try the sidewalk. Haven't done that in a while. Haven't done it here at all. At least keep active. There's a train right there. Just missed it. Little park out there. Staging area for something. Oh, that's Lyndhurst Municipal Lot. Municipal, And we're on the home stretch. If I had been about a mile down the road here, I would have gotten another nice shot of trains. I've gotten that before using a GoPro. It's very cool, actually. It works well. Frank Mighties. And another thing, like the Canada geese, they're all over. A little bit of a movie called The Day of the Triffids. I think it was the 1960s or 70s. Standing right by the electrified fence. Well, that was the movie. Get not just on this bike, but every bike. And this has ergonomic grips. Just get the numbness. I guess years and years of not just bicycling, but years and years of on the motorcycle for long distances with pressure on the palms. Who knows what else? Please help. Putting your hand in another position. Headwind continues. It's windy out. Let's show a view of New York. Here's the cars behind me. May or may not be able to see that. Telephoto lens. Press the scene. There's another place that other people go. That's a pretty good headwind. That's the kind I always get when I'm going south along the Hudson waterfront. They are all blocked off. Doesn't look like they want people even walking on these things. Hopefully they'll open up that trail that goes right in the middle of the marshes. It goes for a good mile, more than a mile. That's cool. And they're going up that mountain. That's very short. Maybe a walking trail gives you a little bit bigger view. In the winter, it's better than now because it's still blocked by the trees. Look at the color of the trees. Right around 7 miles. New York and the marshes to the left, and Environmental Center ahead, and so is the car. No, the car's right here. Mercedes, the old Mercedes looks exactly like the Escape I have. Right over there.